In the last few videos, we constructed a marginal product revenue curve for our little competitive car wash, and we essentially figured out how this is really just the demand curve for labor from this firm. And I talked about in the very first video that if you know the demand curve for in a certain market, and this is the market for labor of a certain kind, maybe the type of labor that would work at a car wash, then if you knew it from one firm and all of the other firms in the market for that type of labor, you could add their demand curves to get the entire market demand for that type of labor, for that good or service. And what I want to do in this video is make sure you understand what it means to add demand curves. It's on one level straightforward, but on another level a little non-intuitive because of the ways that the axes are defined in economics, that the price axis is the vertical axis. So let's draw the demand curve for two firms, and I'll do simplified versions. I won't use this one right over here. I'll just do two simplified demand curves. And this doesn't apply just to labor markets. This applies to any demand curve. So if I want to add two demand curves, so this is one entity's demand. So let's say this is one firm's demand. So that's price, and this is quantity. This is quantity. And let's say at a price of 10, they demand nothing, if that's the hourly wages. And if the price were 0, they would essentially get up to, they would demand 10 people. And so you have a situation, you have a demand curve that would look something, a demand curve that would look something like that. Let me draw it. A demand curve that would look like that. And I'll do one other point on the demand curve. At a price of 5, a quantity or $5 per hour, this firm would demand, if we're thinking of it in terms of labor, at a price of $5 per hour of labor, this firm would demand 5 people per hour. And obviously, what I'm going to do is general to any demand curve, but we'll just keep it in the labor mindset. So this is firm one. This is a firm's demand, firm one. If we're talking about this demand for oranges, then this wouldn't be a firm, this would be a consumer or maybe a wholesaler or something like that. So this is firm one's demand for labor. And let's say firm 2's demand looks something like this. And I'll try to align them. So firm 2's demand looks something like this. And the axes are going to have the exact same labels. This is quantity. This is price right over here. This is 5. This is 10. And then this is 15. And let's say that this is 5. And let's say this is 6 right over here. And their demand curve looks like this. It looks so like that. Let me make it a little bit neater. It looks, that was less neat. It looks something like that. And I could put some extra points here. At a price of 10, this firm will demand 2 units. If we're thinking labor, $10 per hour, they'll get 2 people per hour. At a price of 5, they will demand 4. They will demand 4 units. So these are all, we've looked at a couple of points on this demand curve. And now we are ready to add them together. So this is firm 2. Firm 2's demand for labor. So let's add these two curves. And what I said is unintuitive is that we're actually going to look at, for a given price, how much total quantity of labor is now demanded. So we're going to essentially add it horizontally. And you're going to see what I'm talking about in a second. So when I add them together, I'm going to have the same axes. So this is, let's say this is 5. This is 10. Actually, let me get a little bit further on this axis, on this second axis. So the second axis, I'll make it as straight as possible. So let's say that this is 5, 10, 15. 5, 10, 15, and this is 5, 10, 15. And I'm doing my best to align it horizontally, that this 15 is this 15, that this 10 is with this 10, is with that 10, and that 5 is with that 5, and with that 5. So at a price of 15 in the market, what is the total quantity demanded? Well, it's still going to be 0, because even this firm is still demanding 0. But then if we go to a price of 10, this firm, the firm 1 is demanding 0, but firm 2 over here is demanding 2. So we're going to go 10, it's going to be right over there. This is right about 2. That distance is right about 2. And then if we go to 5, at a price of 5, firm 1 is going to demand 5. Firm 2 is going to demand 4 units of labor. So at a price of 5, you're going to have 5 plus 4. So at a price of 5, you're going to have 5 plus 4, or 9 units of labor. 9 units of labor. And then at a price of 0, if labor is free, this firm would demand 10 units. This firm would demand 6 units. You add them together, you get 16 units. So you'd get 16 units. So the combined demand for labor curve will look something like, I'll do it in blue. The combined demand for labor curve will look like this. Between $15 and $10, only firm one is interested in getting any labor. So this part right over here will look just like that. But then after that point, you can essentially add firm one to the mix. And then firm one, maybe I'll do that part in a different color. It'll look something like that. We've horizontally added this line to this line. You could imagine taking this line, and at any given point, so at 5 right over here, you're taking its value and quantity and adding to this quantity here. And the reason why I said this is a little bit non-intuitive is this would have been easier, at least for me to add, with kind of the background or the traditional algebraic conventions we're used to. We're used to adding kind of vertically. So if we were to flip price and quantity, then we could kind of stack these on top of each other and add them vertically. And that's why it's a little non-intuitive. But hopefully this makes sense. We're just looking at each of their demand curves at any given price. We're seeing, OK, what is the demand from firm 2? What is the demand from firm 1? And we're adding them together. And then we get this combined market demand curve, firm 1 plus firm 2.